the Butcher.
Your following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a three-way match. Introducing first, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 420 pounds, this is Pogo.
These motherfuckers got me in a fucking three-way match tonight. Let me tell you something. Abdullah, the motherfucking Butcher. Let me tell you something, old man. You try to fucking fork me with that motherfucking fork, motherfucker. I'm gonna fucking kick your motherfucking dentures down your fucking throat, boy. You understand me? Jake the fucking Snake. Let me tell you something, boy. You pull that son of a fuck sidekick piece of fuck thing you got in that motherfucking bag, and you put that motherfucker 5 fucking feet from me, motherfucker, I'm gonna fucking carve that fucking son of a bitch up and shove it down fucking Abby's motherfucking throat! You got me, boy? Let me tell you something, boys. You ain't never met nobody like me. I'm the one that might take you out for good, boys. Yeah!
Motherfucker! Fucking fuck!
Pogo the motherfucking clown is here!
Fuck the fuck, yeah, he motherfucking fucking is, motherfucker! Jeez, oh fuck!
How'd you like to wake up with him next to you in bed?
Well, hold on to your motherfucking pants!
That probably only happened in prison, my friend.
I don't give a fuck where it happened. It motherfucking sucked, motherfucker!
Oh, it appears he got a creamy, delicious shake across his back. I hope that was a shake.
The Juggalo's very appreciative of Pogo the Clown tonight.
Well, you can see why. Look how awesome he looks.
Come here, motherfucker! Bend over! Turn around, motherfucker!
Come here, you fucking ref. I'm gonna fucking grab your
Wait
fucking head.
I recognize that fucking ref.
He's that fucking Vulcan from fucking the Starship Enterprise.
Look again, Guido. It's C.J. O'Doyle.
Holy shit. Whoa.
And his opponent, hailing from Sudan, weighing in at 400 pounds, accompanied to the ring by his manager, Honest John Cheatham, here is Abdullah the Butcher!
It's Abdullah the Butcher, the craziest and the wildest man that JCW has ever seen in the world. And we're gonna do it tonight. Hold the mind of Abdullah the Butcher! It shall never be touched, only by one man, and that is me! Tonight, JCW! Bloody Mania!
Check out the belly on the pastry chef.
Holy shit. Those two boys share a lot of fast food on the road.
They share many a buffet. They pay one ticket and they split the fucking buffet bill and they eat all they like.
They close the buffet down every night. Pogo attacking Abdullah the Butcher. Abdullah the Butcher in prime physical condition. Pogo attacking him, repeatedly stabbing him. Right there, you're looking at Pogo the Clown and Abdullah the Butcher, two fabulous athletes.
Well, you heard Pogo saying he's not taking that bullshit by Abdullah with that fucking fork, and he meant it. And that water bottle meant it bouncing off the forehead of Abdullah the Butcher.
Abdullah now trying to get into the ring, giving everything he's got to fit between those ropes, but Pogo not having it.
Hailing from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing in at 260 pounds, here is Jake the Snake Roberts.
And Guido, if you want to talk about athletes, take a look at one right now.
Oh shit, the only snake he came out with was the one in his pants.
There he is. There is a true athletic specimen.
That's right, Mr. Big, if I've ever seen him in my life.
Look at him.
He's ready for action. Look at him. He knows how to brawl. He knows how to fight. And God damn it, he knows how to wrestle.
And he knows how to drink, I'm assuming.
Oh, I believe he knows how to smoke better than drink.
Right now, lightning short arm clothesline knocking Big Pogo down. Jake the Snake came in his finest wrestling attire.
And you'll notice on the back of his shirt it says size. The only size he has is a size on his stomach.
Right now, going for that DDT on Pogo the Clown. No.
Not
Pogo,
so easy.
Not having that shit. Hell no. Oh, Pogo with the bomb-ass elbow right on top of Jake the Snake. Look at Jake the Snake's poor face stuffed between the legs of Pogo the Clown. That has got to be horrific.
Well, let me tell you something right now, 3D.
No, look. Oh, my God.
Oh, God, you're right. Holy shit. That's got to smell like fucking burnt rubber. But on top of that, Pogo the Clown having no respect for these two legends in the ring right now. He's out to win. He's out to fuck these two other guys up.
Shit.
He don't give a fuck if it's Jake the Snake or Abdullah. He's out to fucking pin him 1, 2, 3.
Oh! Another referee slid in and made the count. It looks like somehow, some way, Pogo the Clown has pinned Jake the Snake and Guido.
Jake the Snake's stomach fell out.
Abdullah the Butcher never even made it in the ring. That's as far as he got in right there.
What the fuck just happened here?
I don't know, but I feel like I got the shaft.
I know I got the shaft. See a Pogo making Jake the Snake's stomach fall out.
Jake the Snake not about to have it as he takes the female referee and DDT's her.
He DDT's her.
Wow.
Oh, what a big guy, Mr. Big.
Fuck.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Abdullah never even getting in the ring.
Part of the reason why was because Jake Snake got in there because he thought there was crack in that referee's pocket.
Now, he's picking up the referee again for a second DDT. Due to the Juggalo's request, Jake Snake delivers. Wow.
And he's blew up. He's sweating. He's bleeding somehow. Oh, and he's dry fucking her face.
Unfucking real. Three of the top athletes on the show. Wrap that match up in about 64 seconds.
Hey, call me Miss Cleo, but I had a feeling Pogo was going to win this match. I don't know why.
Well, he was easily the top athletic one of the three.
Who Kevin the fuck Gill. Is this? Kevin Gill?
Yes. Coming down to the ring to help the female referee, whose top of her head has to resemble Frankenstein's now. Completely flattened after dual DDTs from Jake the Snake Roberts and a dick in the mouth to finish things off.
That's right. He DDT'd her to flatten the forehead out so he could dry fuck it properly.
And look what fell out of Jake's pocket, a crushed beer can.
That's right. And maybe that's a piece of licorice or a crack rock. You tell me.
I can't fucking believe it. That, my friends, was a scam. But it happened and you saw it. The winner, Pogo the Clown.
Well, there's a reason right there why women should be referees against dangerous men like Jake the Snake in the Pants.
She's sweet but a psycho, a little bit psycho. At night she's screaming, I'm on my mind, out my mind. Oh, she's hot but a psycho, so left but she's right though.